Everybody, welcome back to my channel. So today I've got a monthly favorites for you guys. July came around so quickly, my goodness gracious, but I thought I'd share with you guys my current beauty favorites slash my monthly favorites. Some of these I've been loving for more than a month, some of these I've been loving this month, so I thought that I'd share these with you guys today. So yeah, if you'd like to see my products, so I'm covering makeup, skincare, tanning, nails, the whole shebang this month. So yeah, if you'd like to see what I've been loving and what I have not been loving, just keep watching. For foundation, I don't know if I've mentioned this in a previous video, but the Too Faced Born This Way foundation, my goodness, it is so beautiful. I've got three shades that I alternate between. So I've got Almond, which is quite light. Obviously, this would not match me today. I've got Light Beige, which is a beautiful color for if I've got a mild fake tan on. And then I've also got Sand, which is quite dark, and I use that with Light Beige to get my custom color if I'm a bit darker. And I love it so much. So radiant, so glowy, so perfect on the skin, and it offers a beautiful medium buildable coverage. This product here is moisturizer, and it's honestly been a savior to my skin. I'm so glad I picked it up, because since I've incorporated this into my skincare, I definitely have not gotten as many breakouts as what I once had. So my goodness, this has been a savior for me. This is the Avene Rich Compensating Cream. And it's just absolutely beautiful. It is expensive. I have used quite a lot already. Like, you can see, like, I've already, like, scraped, like, the sides and stuff. So I don't have that much left. I've probably used about half, or maybe just a bit under half. But my goodness, this has been great. I use this normally in the evening, but I use it sometimes in the mornings as well. This product is absolutely beautiful, and I'm so glad that I gave Avene a shot, because I've always thought it was quite expensive, especially for Priceline. But I was like, you know what? I'm going to give it a go, because it seems very simple but still very good, and oh my goodness, it's so, so good. I think this is normally $60, but you know what? If it works, it works, and I love it so much. Also from Avene is their sunscreen. Now, I thought that I'd show you both of them. This is my old bottle and this is my new bottle. This is how much I love this stuff, and sorry if I sound a bit congested. I am currently dealing with a cold, which is not the greatest thing in the world, so I'm so sorry if you can hear that in my voice. But the Avene SPF 50, this is the very high protection broad spectrum sunscreen. It's water resistant for 40 minutes and it's for sensitive skin. So I don't have technically the most sensitive skin in the world, but I had been breaking out a lot prior to introducing Avene products into my skincare. And my God, like, this stuff is so great. Like, you can see how much I've used of this. Like, it's almost all gone. Like, I'm not going to use any more of this because I'm going to take it traveling with me. But I'm currently using this one now, and I've already used so much of it. I love how there's a pump mechanism to it, because you can really distribute the right amount of product. For me, 2.5 pumps will do my face and my neck, and then pretty much my work uniform covers up the rest. So I really love this stuff so much, and I love how it's in a pump. You do sadly only get 50 mils, but it's not too expensive at the same time. I think it's around maybe $28, which $28, which I don't think is too expensive, but it's not the cheapest thing in the world. But it's a really, really good product, and it has not broken me out. I'm just going to throw in a little bit of fake tan while I'm on the skin component. This is the Le Tan Uber Dark. So I love this stuff so much. This is the green one. I have not tried the other ones, but I did pick up the Marula one as well, and I'm excited to give that one a try, but I've only tried the green one so far. I've used a full bottle. This is my second bottle, and oh my goodness, I love this so, so much. It's a very red tan. It's not orange. It is very red, and it looks very, very natural. It looks like you've been burnt but tanned at the same time. I love it. This is it at the moment. This is only one light layer. Normally, I'll do two or three layers of this stuff, and I'm so, so dark, and it lasts almost the whole week. I would say it probably starts fading around Thursday, which, to be honest, is quite a good day for me personally, because I scrub it off and I just apply more, or I just put it over the top. For my bronzer, I've been loving the Chanel Soleil Tan de Chanel again. I've kind of been in a love-hate relationship with this for quite some time, but I've been loving it at the moment. I'm sure in a few months I'll put it down and I'll be like, eh. But for the moment, I'm really, really liking it. I've been painting it on now and then blending it out, while I used to go in with my brush directly and then apply it to my face. So I've been really liking that method. So yeah, Chanel Soleil Tan de Chanel has been a good one. For traditional bronzing slash contouring, I've been loving the Sleek Contour Kit in the shade Light. You can see I've made quite a divot in it or at least I hope you can see that I've made quite a divot in it. It's really, really great. I'm sure I'll hit pan on it soon. The highlighter is okay. I don't really use it too much. I really love this for the bronzer though. It's great and it's quite affordable from Target in Australia. For highlighter, I've really, really, really been loving too. So I've been loving the W7 Glow Comotion, and this is the more yellow one. They don't really have names, I don't think. It does say down here SL09HW, which I don't know what that means. I'm very sorry, but this is a beautiful highlighter. It's actually what I have on my cheeks today. It's so, so gorgeous. Here, I'll show you exactly what it looks like. And then I've also been loving the MAC Extradimension Skin Finish in the shade Oh Darling. So this one's been in my collection for a while, but I've really just not used it. But my boyfriend actually saw it and was like, why don't you use this? Because like sometimes when he's over, I get him to pick my makeup. So yeah, there's this one as well. This one is absolutely gorgeous as well. This one's a little bit more intense, a little bit more golden, but they're both so, so, so beautiful. So the top one is Oh Darling. The bottom one is the W7 one. Rewind a little bit to concealer. I have been loving my Kevin Aucoin Sensual Skin Enhancer again. This is in the shade SX06. I also have SX03 and SX08, which I also really like to use, but I've just had a lot more events recently and I've been whipping this out, and my goodness, I just love it so much. I get into a rut with this where I only use it like every so often and I forget about it, and then I'll use it again and then I'll love it again. So yeah, I love this product so, so much. It's so great. And if you are in the market for a good quality concealer, definitely check out the Kevin Aucoin, because it is definitely worth it. Like, it is about $60 or $70, but you're getting 18 grams. Like, that's almost as much as what's in that Douay high coverage thing. Like, I don't know, but that's what I think. Like, this stuff is great. It's super, super pigmented and it's just so beautiful. Through this video, I'm going to share with you guys some products that I don't like as well. So there has been two products that I discovered that I don't like. The first one is the Tartist Clay Play Liner. I personally don't like this. For some reason, when this comes in contact with eyelash glue, it literally looks like the eyelash glue literally looks white. And even if I try and put more over the top, then it starts caking up. And oh my God, it's just like the worst time ever. This would only work if you either had lash extensions, which I personally wouldn't wear liner if I had lash extensions, or if you were just wearing like your normal lashes with some mascara or no mascara and then just wanting like a liner. That's the only time I would ever use this again, because I've used this several times when I've done a wing, put on lashes, and no joke, it just looks plain out white when my glue is dry. I use duo lash adhesive. I've always used duo lash adhesive. I went through a phase where I was trying different like lash adhesives besides duo, but I've used duo lash adhesive for years with liner, without liner, and I know that stuff dries clear. And for some reason, when paired with this, it still is white. And I understand you can buy the dark lash glue and it should dry, but I shouldn't have to do that. I've never had to do that. Why should I have to do it now? It's definitely this. Like, to be honest, I don't even like this that much, like, to apply. Like, it was very weird. Like, I didn't know how much I was actually had on my brush. It was really hard, like, because I used the brush that came with it. And no joke, I had, like, extra here when I was touching my eye, and it literally just smeared. So I had to, like, make a makeshift halo eye, like, randomly, because, like, it didn't dry properly. Like, ugh. Anyway, rant over. I personally don't like this. I've given it a lot of chances and I don't really like it. I'm going to try and use it day to day just to use it up. But to be honest, like, for the price, I don't want to have to, like, I don't want it to look bad, you know? Like, I'm paying a high-end price for an eyeliner, which I could go to Maybelline and buy, like, an eyeliner, you know what I mean? So I want this to perform, and it does not do that. This combo I've been loving so, so much. It's so beautiful. It's the Inglot Duraline. So a lot of people have heard of that on YouTube, but also this pigment. So I've mixed two drops of this Duraline with this pigment here, and it's seriously so beautiful, so forward, so amazing. This is in the shade 123. It's a beautiful like white, pinky, gold color. It's what I have on my eyelids today. It's so beautiful, so gorgeous. I love it so, so much. And yeah, it's just the most beautiful. I don't really want to swatch it because swatching it dry doesn't really do it justice, but that's what it looks like in the pan and or in the little pot. It's great. I love this stuff so, so much. It's definitely worth the money. If you are looking for pigments in your over MAC, definitely give Inglot a try because I love Inglot pigments so much. I think I've got like 5 or 6. Love them so much. And they have quite a lot of like dupes for MAC, and I personally think they have more variety, so you cannot go wrong. Oh my god, this product, I hate it so much. Like, I hate it. I know a lot of people like it, but I do not like it. This is the Nude by Nature Natural Mineral Cover in the shade Medium. This stuff oxidizes like no other. I have used this several times as well. Same with the Tarte thing. Ew. I've used this several times with several different foundations that I know perform well and do not oxidize with any other powder. And it literally makes me look straight out orange. Like, this stuff makes me look straight out orange. I'm so glad this is the sample. I'm so glad that Priceline sent this to me as like a, I don't know, like a loyalty customer thing. I don't even know. Like, it was just sitting at the back of my drawer and I was like, let's use this. And ew. Like, because obviously the full size is like a lot bigger because this is only like the 2 gram sample. Thank God I got it in a sample because I was literally going to buy the full size. I was literally going to buy the full size. And then I got this in the mail and I was like, woohoo. Like, I never get PR. This, I wouldn't count this as PR. So I called to complain. I end up with this in the mail. Whatever. That's how I got this. I did not pay for it. That's why mine looks small. I hate this. This is the worst thing ever. Bye. For my nails, I've been liking this trio. My gosh, I was gonna drop it. So the first one is the Aucoin Nail Envy. This one is the matte version, I think. I just apply this to my nails just as a base to strengthen my nails, but to also, I guess, provide a base. So I really like that. And then I go in with this red nail polish, and it's in the shade 554. It's like their most beautiful, like, rich red. I currently don't have anything on my nails because I'm just letting my nails breathe, but there's that. And then I go over the top with the Revlon Color Stay Gel Envy Diamond Top Coat. This stuff is great as well. Now, I feel like that OPI stuff really makes a difference because I've painted my nails with the OPI like throughout the whole month, but then the last time I painted my nails, which was last weekend, no joke, it was just peeling off my nails. Like, the nail polish, like, just these two together would peel off my nails. So I feel like this really does have a contributor. This makes it shine so much, and this is so opaque. So I really like all three of them. I'm normally just like a one color and go, but ever since incorporating the three together, oh my gosh, life has been changed. Oh. For eyeshadow, my Z palette, I actually bought a medium size Z palette. I have no idea what color this is. To be honest, I wish I got the black because it gets so dirty. Like, I don't know if you can see that there, but it actually gets so dirty. So I wish I got the black one, but whatever. Change is good. Wedge, got to love Wedge. I love Wedge so much. I have it in my crease, but you might not be able to see it because I've got a little bit of this color as well, which I feel like overpowers it a little bit. And then nylon, I have it on my brow bone at the moment. Oh my goodness, I've been loving the Intense brow bone highlight recently. Oh, I love it so much. And just the Z palette medium in a whole, like, I've been loving my Z palette medium because I'm able to fit my eyeshadows, but then I can also fit two bigger, like, bigger pan things as well. And I just love it. Like, I love the size. I can't believe that it's taking me so long to get on the bandwagon with this size. But yeah, and don't get me wrong, I don't regret any of my other Z palettes because they're more like a storage style Z palette. But on the go, I can't believe I used to travel with an extra large Z palette all the time. Like, that's ridiculous. I think the medium is definitely a more sufficient size. And lucky last is lips. So for lips, I have been going to a few events, hence why I mentioned the Kevin Aucoin concealer. So I have been wanting lipsticks that last and that look well and photograph nicely. So what I normally do when I'm getting ready is I'll put on my Too Faced Lip Injection Extreme. I find this really does plump up my lips. It really just depends person to person if this will work for you. It does work for me. It is really painful, like, I won't lie, like, it's a very, very strong tingle, but it does make my lips look more plump and bigger. So I will apply this, and then if I'm going between functions, like, for example, if I'm going from a ceremony to a reception dinner, then I'll apply it, like, in the car while we drive to the other thing, take it off, and then I'll apply one of these. If I want like a true nude, then I will either use my Stila Caramello liquid lipstick. This is a beautiful one. I love this so much. I sometimes mix it with Bow and Arrow as well, but I've just been using Caramello alone. Or I top it with Honey Love by MAC. Honey Love by MAC is a staple for me. I've been loving it for years and years and years and years. I've loved it for so long and I will forever love it. Or if I want a more pinky color, then I use Lovecraft from Kat Von D. This is a beautiful, like, beautiful, romantic, mauvey, but not too purple pink. It's great. Okay guys, so that is all my favorites and dislikes for the month of July. Definitely let me know what you thought in the comments down below. And yeah, hopefully I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.